gün burada döndüm yedim. Onlar mıdım için boyuna gel. Dağır darnam zan taşımı doğdum. Batı dekan laki şahım zanır.
Ha. Şimdiye.
Today we'll continue with the teaching of Sigalavada Sutra. In the previous classes, I think I've already announced the schedule of this week. That is today, tomorrow, and day after tomorrow. In the 3 days, we will have the class on the Sigalavada Sutra. Next week, I think we'll have one or two more classes which will conclude the whole teaching of Sigalavada Sutra. It's really wonderful that we can finish studying this sutra. I didn't know that we can study this sutra. In my previous classes, I quoted from this particular sutra, but didn't really have time to study it carefully. But this time, through teaching and studying with all of you, I actually learned a lot from it, and I had the opportunity to compare different editions, including the edition from Agama Sutra as well as the other editions. But this particular sutra, or different editions of this particular sutra, are rather different than the ones of the Vimalakirti Sutra, because Vimalakirti Sutra, most of the content are mostly similar, but in terms of this particular sutra, there are lots of differences. Not sure what the reasons are. Therefore, it's quite important to pick different versions. But through studying this particular sutra, I think I've really learned a lot. I really like the content, and I think it's very timely for householders nowadays. Running nose is the most difficult to deal with during classes. If it's places where it's aching me but not visible to you, that would be much better, but I can't hide it, so. I'd better come over this particular difficulty, as runny nose is not a big deal either. I really hope for those of you who, after studying this sutra, could promote and disseminate the teaching of this sutra, because as of now, 80 to 90% of our audience are householders. And for householders, some teachings may be too difficult. When we're talking about Prajnaparamita, emptiness, and Mahayana, profound teachings of Mahayana, it will be difficult to completely grasp the profound meanings of those. And there are teachings that probably doesn't really have too much of a relevance to those of you who are householders, such as the Vinaya aspect. But when we are promoting this Buddha Dharma infused in life, in such teachings, in such philosophy and guidelines, then these teachings are very fitting to your life, and it could be very practical to you and other people's life. In the future, I really hope that you could promote this teaching, the teaching of helping people to engage Buddhism into their lives. Where the teaching could be very practical to people's mundane family life as well as career. I think it's quite important for people to be benefited from such practical teachings. Otherwise, it would be otherwise, it would be rather unnecessary if we only listen to the great profound teachings, but unable to use them in our lives. And so it's important to learn some practical guidelines that's simple to understand and simple to practice. And it's very important to learn the profound teachings of Buddha Dharma as well. You really need both aspects. If we only talk about the profound aspect, it's hard to implement them into our daily life. So we do need some practical teachings. So studying Siglavada Sutra and implement the guideline to our lives are extremely important. We've talked about the bad friends or the friends who may appear as friends but are really enemies disguised as friends. We've studied that last class. There were 16 types of them. And today we're going to talk about the four good-hearted friends. You can really look at your own life and think about all the people around you and see who are your real good friends and who are benefiting you and how you should treat them. In the previous one, we've already talked about how one should treat or how one should recognize the enemies who are disguised as friends. Well, in any cases, in our daily life, in our studies, we should at least pick one or two points that's really important. We should be able to remember that one or two points even after a decade or two. That would be very meaningful and very helpful to you. And over here, the Buddha told Sikalaka and saying that there are four types of friends whom you can associate yourself with. And once you associate yourself with such kind of friends, then you'll be benefited from many different aspects. They will bring great help and benefit to you. They can help you out of great difficulties, and you will lead a meaningful life with their help as well. So who are the four types of good-hearted friends then? The first one is the mentor. Is the kind of friend who would stop you from doing harmful things. The second one is compassionate friend who holds a kindness and a friendliness towards others and has a mind of benefiting others often. That's the second type of friend. The third one is the helper. Within their activity, they will always be able to help others. They have the intention of helping others. And the fourth one is the kind of friend who would help others through their own actions. And once you associate yourself with these four types of friends, they could bring great benefits and help to you. That's the summary.
According
To a sutra where it says that the according to the commentary where it says that the first one who is a mentor, he would act more as a friend where stops you from evil speech, and the second type, which is compassionate friend, who would stop you from evil mind. And then third and fourth type of friends, they are more towards the guidelines of or guide you in terms of your actions. However, if you look at this, there are different aspects within each one, and they don't completely follow the speech, mind, and action aspect.
有可能就是互相都有一些这个交叉的吧 就是互相都有一些交叉的
And there are things that goes across
什么办法呢 是不是声音不好听？这样的话呢，看看怎么样啊？就是，就刚才讲了，就是这个亲友的话呢，就是在这边。
The friends has four categories or four types of good-hearted friends. According to the romantic legends of Shakyabuddha, it says that briefly I speak of the notion of genuine friends. There are three types of friends, or the friends that has three types of characteristics. The first one is admonish you against evilness. Second, encourage you in goodness, and then the third one is lend you a helping hand when you are in trouble. Whoever does these is called a genuine friend. The first one is that the friend will admonish you against evilness. The second one is encourage you to practice virtue. The third one is whenever you encounter any obstacles, they are willing, more than willing to lend you a helping hand. I've also contemplated on this content. In our daily life, if we have such great friends, then how wonderful is that? The kind of friend who often asks you not to practice the immoral actions and always encourage you to practice virtuous actions and always ready to help you. When people have fame and status and wealth, people around you tend to be very friendly towards you, but whenever you are in a difficult situation, they will abandon you without any concern for you. Therefore, the kind of friend, according to a kind of good friend, according to Sikkhalabhada Sutra, is that there are four types of friends.
还有呢，就是像那个瑜伽师地论。
And according to Yogacara Shastra, a compendium of Yogacara Shastra, it recorded about eight aspects of a good friend. First one is the one who listens and studies extensively. Second one is who has a certain level of inner realization. Third one is who has compassion. Third one is who does not have any tiresome mind. And so on. There are eight types of qualities of the mind. of a good friend. So as a Buddhist, when you want to associate, whenever you want to associate yourself with a good friend, you should really observe their action, whether if that person has a good precept, or whether if that person has compassion, whether if that person studies and listens extensively, whether if that person
is very sturdy-minded
and not wavering from one or two obstacles, and then feel tired of being with them. Just any little things will make them feel really tired and bothered. So these kind of friends are not worth of associating yourself with. When a person
it's
okay, you can show my image. I'm not doing anything terrible.
That's
the summary.
略缩的话, 那就是大概是这样讲的。 下面呢, 就是, 就讲到刚才那个这四种法呢, 就是都一一的光说啊, 就是光说呢,
and then the next part.
这个,
刚才智慧呢，就是四种啊，就总共是六种人。那么这个也许是可能，就是这是四六种的话呢，就是可能不同的。但大多数看到呢，就是可能。
The first one is the mentor can be identified by four things.
By restraining you from wrongdoing, guiding you towards good actions, telling you what you ought to know, and showing you the path to the heaven realm.
就是包括可能这个偷盗啊，就是这个欺骗啊。
Whenever a mentor friend who sees that you are about to have any non-virtuous actions such as stealing and so on, then a good mentor friend will advise or admonish you against such evilness. According to Confucius, he said that there are five ways of giving advice. The first one is
什么钢剑啊, 就是还有巨剑啊, 就是不痛的, 就是有些是什么呢,
direct advice, rude advice, and advice that's given rather subtly.
还有一些是叫那个相劝, 就在他面前的话呢, 就是非常那个恭敬的, 就是,
another one is respectfully giving the advice.
还有呢, 就是有什么那个, 什么这个威劝, 是吧? 就是意思就是说呢,
also,
就是比较婉转的这种语言呢, 就是让他,
use really subtle ways
有些人的话呢,
of hinting the other person
就是就直接给他在,
to give advice. There are people who are so used to give other people advice
这样的话呢,
in public
别人,
and pointing to the others. And criticizing them in public. And in such a way, I think the other person won't be able to accept your advice with an open heart. Rather, your relationship with the other person may then go down the drain.
But
if you can adapt a different method of teaching or giving advice to the other person, you will still be friends. And your idea will get to the other person. So that's the first characteristic of a mentor friend. The second characteristic is
Guiding you towards good actions, and good actions such as the merit of releasing life and the merits of stopping killing. By stating such merits of good actions, then you'll be able to, then such a mentor friend will be able to guide you onto the path of virtue. The third one is that telling you what you ought to know with compassion. According to the commentary, if the commentary is correct, then all of the four should be associated with speech. But over here, because the kindness is not really associated with the speech, therefore it's not completely fitting to that commentary. The fourth one is to show one the path of, or to the heaven, to the heaven, or to the better rebirth. So a good mentor friend not only care about where you're going to in this lifetime, but also the next lifetimes to come. They will help you to practice good and stop all the evil actions. I think you will be able to think of a few friends who guided you. During your path towards the Dharma, I think there are friends who made great impact to you. Along the path, there are people who also followed the path, who also advised you or guided you through the path as well. There's a sutra, the name of the sutra is the merit-filled sutra, where it tells the story of Ananda, the previous life of Ananda. Because of the guidance of the friend of the previous life of Ananda, he was able to be reborn in the three higher realms. So the story goes that when Ananda was just a citizen in the society, and he had lots of ulcers and has pus in it, and he was suffering from it. At that time, he met a person who said, well, if you could go and bathe yourself in the bathing water of the Sangha, of the monastics, then you'll be able to cleanse yourself, and you'll be able to cure your ulcers. So he then went into a monastery, and he washed himself inside the bathing water of where all the monastics bathe. And because of this, he was healed, he was recovered from all the ulcer, and for lifetimes he was very healthy. So it was all because of the friend's advice. Some say it's the previous life of Ananda. Some say that it's some other monastic whose name was Ananda. It could be that it is Ananda because he knows his previous life through the miraculous power of attaining arhathood, but he didn't attain arhathood during Buddha's lifetime, so it could be also another monastic whose name is also Ananda, so it has two possibilities. Therefore, through the help or suggestion of a friend, he was able to be cured from his ulcers.
ulcers. And through the helping hand of a friend, I think you also probably remembered how your friend helped you. And through such kind of help, you probably have the mind of gratitude from them. By reading another sutra, which is the Sutra of Wise and the Foolish, it says that the foolish averts non-virtue and propagate virtue in order to make the virtue widely known to the general public. So the one with virtue will propagate the virtuous actions by speech and as well as their own actions so that they can guide other people, they can guide the general public to the virtuous path. Therefore, for people who are practicing Mahayana path, I think you should often share the teachings that's very helpful to yourself and that might be very helpful to others, just as it is stated in the Sutra of the Wise and the Foolish. You could share the idea that the virtuous actions could bring them happiness and so on. That would be very meaningful to both you and others. These four types of characteristics could be compounded or could be altogether, could be shown altogether in one person or different people.
People
work very hard for their longevity, for their happiness, for their enjoyment of forms and the five skandhas. In order to gain longevity, they may go killing of other animals. In fact, you may feel that this would bring the cause of longevity, but killing really doesn't. Not only in this lifetime, you may receive the fruition, the maturation of the fruition of killing, your next lifetimes will also be suffered from the fruition of killing, such as born in lower realm or born in a poor family or have a short lifespan and poor health and so on. Karma is really the most important aspect of understanding the Dharma and understanding your life. People may feel that, why me? Why I am so unlucky? You may feel that I am a reasonable person. I've done such good actions. But without understanding your karma could be just the manifestation of the karma in this lifetime and maybe just the maturation of your previous lifetimes. So the mundane beings don't understand the karmic causes and
fruitions.
We don't even understand how the farmers planting food, planting, sowing the seed and the crops could grow. In fact, the karma could be could come to fruition or maturation, not only in this lifetime, but sometimes it could have a time lag in between where your karma in this lifetime could be matured in next lifetime. So it's quite important to understand that it doesn't get matured right away, and there is a time lag, and that's how karma works. And by understanding this, whatever happens in your life is not necessarily come true right now. Just as today, I Just as if I supplicate to the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, and then I will stop, have runny nose. Of course, I didn't do that because it's just a small thing to bother the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, and that's not what I did. But my point is that maybe it doesn't right away come to fruition that maybe I'll get recovered right away. So this kind of fruition, maturation of the fruition, has also the contribution of good friends or bad friends, and the good friends or bad friends could lead you to lower realms or higher realms, to happiness or sadness in this lifetime or even next lifetimes. The next one is that the compassionate friend, whenever the compassionate friend whosoever sees that you are enjoying success, they will rejoice. Just as they are enjoying such a success. The second one is whenever they see that you are going through a hard patch and they are very worried about you. May the first, it's a holiday, and I know you're tourists and you are just departing halfway through. If I really hope that you could finish the whole class, otherwise it's not really auspicious. For some of you who never really listened to any Dharma class, you only listen to half of it. It is not auspicious to only listen to half of it. If you only listen to half, maybe this is your only one class. And it's not even the whole class yet. I'll teach for another half an hour. So maybe just be patient and listen to this for this class. You came a long way to here. Then as long since you're already here, might as well just stay here and listen to the class. I do understand that people are interested or curious about Buddha Dharma, and you might be curious about it. I know you've probably never been to a shrine hall to listen to the Dharma class, but you've been to schools. You've received education in schools, isn't it? Therefore, it's exact. Therefore, actually, we have exactly the same rules over here. If you don't even excuse yourself from class and just left the class, your teachers won't be happy. So the same rule applies over here in the shrine hall. Anyhow, I'm sorry if I've offended you, but I have too many people walking past in front of my eyes and it's distracting me. Let's continue with the class. The next one is, it says that the friend whomsoever is a good friend to you, they will try to praise people's virtue, especially when they will try to tell others about your good qualities. And then the fourth aspect is that whenever they hear people talking about bad rumors behind your back, they will try to stop it for you. So the four qualities constitute the kind of good friend who are compassionate, who is a compassionate friend. And this kind of friend is very much of a benefit to you. They will try to help you in such situations. This is the friend who has a compassion. Whenever we see that people who are enjoying their success, then as a good friend, we should rejoice their success. For a friend who is not compassionate, maybe even on the surface, it seems that you are friends. But you could be just friends on the surface. surface, but competitively in both of your minds. Whomsoever as your friend, whomsoever is your friend, is enjoying great success and enjoying great wealth. At that time, what's your mind? Are you happy for them or are you competitive with them? When people are enjoying their success, come from your heart, you feel a sense of rejoice. Of course, the West and the East have different ways of pursuing so-called success in their life. In the East, it's very normal to search for fame, to build a good reputation, and people would often feel that it's wonderful that this person cares about his good reputation or her good reputation and so on. But in the East, I think people do not tend to be more pure and lofty about wealth. They don't think pursuing wealth is a good thing. It's not lofty in their idealism anymore. But in the West, it's very different. As long as a person gained the wealth and the stature through legal path, through legal ways, although even if the ways that they accumulated their wealth and fame is rather not so much in accordance with morality, then they are still considered as successful. Through ways that's immoral, if one gain fame and gain wealth in the East, the tradition is that although this person may appear to be successful, they are still looked down at because the methods of gaining such are not in accordance with morality. To the difference that Easterners and Westerners, we should not try to unify all of our methods. We should not try to learn from the West at all areas and all aspects. Yes, the technological advancement in the West are quite great, and we should study from them, but the East has such rich base and such rich morality and rich philosophy, and kind-heartedness, a tradition of kind-heartedness, and those also contributed so much to the world. That kind of tradition of the East should not be changed. So my point is that try to maintain your own tradition and not learning from others blindly. Anyhow, I'm not going to be too I'm not going to explain here too extensively over here. My point is that a good friend who is compassionate will rejoice your success, will help, will worry about you when you're in trouble, will often praise you in front of others and stop others' rumor and slandering you behind your back. This is the kind of friend who is compassionate.
According
to Mipham Rinpoche's The Teaching of the Just King, he said that you know with certainty who your friends are if they help you when you're in trouble. When you are having obstacles and when you are not successful, and then you notice who your friend is, who your friend really is, because as in Tibet we say that when you're successful, even the birds in the sky will come and help you. But when you're not, even if even your birth mother won't come and help you. So only you will know who the true friends are when you are in difficult situations, when you're unsuccessful.
需要帮助的时候你就根本没有就然后一旦就是别人好像优秀的时候呢你就心里面就想起来他的那这种人的话呢可能不是这个很好的这个朋友、啊、
you have to be a good friend first
就是我们上一节课的话呢 就降到了一个人到国外去回来应接的时候呢他的财宝全部都是放在大象上就是那就他当时是怎么样的、
the kind of friend like last time how like that like last time the story I told when a person is successful and came back with elephants full of wealth
The
all of his relatives and friends came out to welcome him, and he recognized that they really just wanted his wealth and not to welcome him.
那最后这个四个方呢，就是讲什么呢？就是利亚，就还有
the third one.
啊，我太逛了，我就马上，不能太。
Okay, I probably spent too much time explaining the first two. The third one is the helper, the friend who is a helper. The first one is protecting, protecting you when you are vulnerable, and telling you what makes you vulnerable, such as drinking, smoking, and so on. So a good friend.At the time when you are,
然后第二种呢，讲保护你呢，就是这个方以这个食材，因为你太方以的话呢，就是你的这个所有的这些财富的话都可能失去了啊。这好的朋友的话呢，经常帮助你，不要供养的太多了，不然你自己也没有钱了。不要去放生，你放生，你连自己的生活都没办法解决，还放什么生啊？
You won't be able to have enough money to go back home. Do not spend too much money in terms of releasing life and doing all those meritorious things. Do not spend too much money on luxurious items. I think some Buddhists are too luxurious or too... Some Buddhists tend to be too devoted and they don't really think about their financial situation and to make offering without concerning about how their basic lifestyle could be met after making great big offerings. So as a good friend, will advise them
with reasons, 就是不让失去这个，让你不要理财啊，不要这个投资啊，就是别人会说是什么这个不理财的话，那财不利你啊，就是有各种说法。但是这个也是有风险的，有危险的。
Because it comes with great risk, and you have to really evaluate how much risk you are willing to take.
第三者呢，就是
by advising you with such reasons, that's a good friend. That's a good friend's action.
心不空过啊，有些人就是产生。
The third one is to protect
the
protect the
因为疾病的原因呢，心里就是又困惑，晚上这个睡不好啊，就有这种各种情况。过一段时间呢，就没有事了，就是就很好了。所以真正好的朋友的话呢，给别人这种戒除这个恐惧。那么第四者呢，就是贫穷较劲，也就是说，这个就私下呢，就是对你就是经常就是有这个一些这个教验吧，就是让你这个不空过啊，不放逸啊，还有很多的这个对你的这个身心有利的就是这些教诫。那么具有这四种这个利人呢，就是也是多说这个绕语，就是为他人呢就是庇护。意思就是说呢，就是我们这个修行人的话呢，就是也是具有。
considered a beneficial friend, a helpful friend.
那就是我们应该是依着他他的啊，就经常保护你，也经常对你不产生恐惧，经常呢就是有各方面的这样的教养的话呢，也是是很重要的。我朋友母亲在那个军规教养里面，孙登子跟他。
Mipa Rinpoche is the teaching given by the Just the King. It says that abandon the bustle of this life, but if you cannot do so, then associate with the good friends, the kind of good friends who have a good right mindfulness.
如果实在是不能断除的话呢，那你应该一直一个。
If you cannot eradicate all the distractions in this life, at least associate yourself with good friends who have right mindfulness and who are good people. Then this kind of friend is the medicine for this distracted life.
这些都是应该断除。如果你实在是断不了的话呢，那你应该就是一直一个很好的朋友的话，这就是他的妙药。
When you are so involved with this samsaric world, then and cannot stop such distraction, then at least what you should do is to associate yourself with the kind of good people who are good practitioners and who have right mindfulness. Of course, as mundane beings, it's very easy.It's not reasonable to require you to be perfect, but when you are distracted by this samsaric world, you should then putting in some effort in associating yourself with the people who are good at studying, contemplating, and practicing.
I think
by reciting this stanza will make all the people, all the practitioners who are good at studying and listening.
That's
the third one. And then the fourth one is the kind of friend who help you through their own actions.It also has four aspects, four qualities. The first one is not to care about their own life and their own anything selfish, but they will help you.
And
the second one is that they do not...
空掉就然后就是救他就是这样的，然后第三者的话呢，就是也是为了解决
They're not selfish about their wealth. They'll
他不欠一切，
lend a helping hand to you whenever you are in need.
第四者呢，就话也是刚才跟前面的，刚才这个什么那个偏向教界的话呢，就是他可能通过其他途径来就是做的，但这个呢，他就亲自就是去这个就私下呢就是想尽一切办法就是劝解他，比如说他误入歧途啊，他就以这个恶有这个相。
Try to advise you through different ways when you are having a private conversation together. So through different skillful
means.
And one who could practice all four of those, they are real kind of, they're the real good-hearted friends who can bring benefits. A good friend will not lie to you, will not deceive you. This is very important. In fact, not just friends. In some of the Buddhism stories, there are stories.
About how
friends should be and how a good friend will not deceive you. There's a story about
a
monkey who has two.
然后那个
babies,
狮子那个就是
two cups, and then,
狮子呢，就是当时那个就带在那个在哪里的时候呢，他就睡着了。就睡着了以后的话呢，就是他的那个刚才米克给他交代的两个孩子的话呢，被那个什么那个旧鸟，就是也是一个大的，是大鹏还是银鸠，就是那个旧鸟。
The lion,
他呢就是把那个孩子，因为他很饿，就是准备吃掉那个两个孩子，让他带走。他带走了以后呢，就是过一会儿，就是他就醒过来了。 他醒过来了以后呢
fall asleep,
然后那个
and then a vulture
就是好像把那个
approached,
就是鸠鸟呢把那个孩子的是拖到那个树上就是然后狮子也跑到上去
babies,
这个时候呢就是狮子就
the lion then at that time
就是鸠鸟就是说啊就是你是那个鸟种
begged the vulture
那个是
saying that you are、
那个、
I am the king of animals and you are the king of birds
什么命的那些孩子呢就是
so could you please
就是我刚才睡着了就是
the,
然后、
babies of the monkey to me
因为我们那个是这个好朋友两个过往就是这样，这样没有必要的，就是
You're the king of birds and I'm the king of animals. So let's not have such conflict with each other.
不能做对他多对不起的事情。但是那个鸠鸟的话呢，就是他说我实在没办法，我太饿了。如果我不吃他的话，我会饿死的。所以我没办法，不能满足你的要求。但这个时候呢，就是狮子就是说把自己的这个身体里面就是切一些肉，给给什么呢？给给鸠鸟。然后呢，
cut open his own flesh and feed the
vulture. That's when
the vulture returned
the
two monkeys to
him.
It could be true, could not be, but the point is that as a good friend, they can really give up anything and everything for
会出现的就是以前那个有一个老堪布原籍的那个堪布区他经常用我们那边的家乡的一个故事我家乡的一个叫那个故事叫那个 Monkey Hutter 就是 Hutter 的一个人他跟那个另外一个部落的我们那个部落叫做鲁库马部落他跟另外一个部落的也是叫贡洛就是什么那个
and from another tribe, his name is Gunlo.
什么啊？对，然后他们两个是就是怎么讲啊？就是那种这个结义兄弟吧，就以前经常有这种结拜，就是这种兄弟。而且藏地的这种习惯的话呢，就是我们一生当中都是，不管是遇到什么事情，就像亲生兄弟一样，我们有个发誓，就是在三宝面前发誓，就是互相要帮助。
Once they sworn to be brothers, then they will treat each other as blood brothers and will not betray each other. That's the kind of tradition in the Tibet once the two people swear in front of the three jewels, they will abide such.
就在这个时候呢，就是他里面刚才那个所谓的那个公罗的话呢，他看到就是他的朋友就是说他在外面的那个就包围着他，他们拉着枪，然后呢就他说是我就是什么这个公罗，就是就他就叫他的名字就是。
Inside the other parties, army. And then at that time, he said that my name is Gung Lob, and then he dropped off his gun and started running towards his friend. And his friend asked all of his people, all of the people from his tribe, to drop the gun and not to harm him. The chief of the friend.
Tribe
then said that, why did you do that? Why did you let him go? Because this will, this actually, this was a great opportunity for us to defeat them, but because of your mistake of letting him go and dropping all the guns of your own tribal army, you.Alone, let us lost this great opportunity. And then the friend explained to his chief why he did so. By listening to this whole story, the chief not only didn't punish him, but promoted him and kept him beside him because Because the chief Gunpa Dengye said that although you lost us a great opportunity of defeating the other tribe, but at least you are a good man who keep to your own words.
就像他一样的这个客观，即使遇到了就最关键，千钧一发，就是那个时候的话，那就是他都不会退缩。
You should be like a friend who is ready to help the others, help your friend who is even in such urgent situations. But nowadays, people really just look at any kind of interpersonal relationships with a sense of practicality. Is it practical to have a relationship? Is it practical to have a friendship? Is it practical to help the others? Is if this is not practical for me to receive any help from you, then what's the point of having a friendship? That's how modern people nowadays to have any relation, any friendship. There was a story of during World War II, a child who is the son of a German official, and he was around 8 or 9 years old. He was very lonely, and then he discovered a place where he actually discovered a place where there are children around his similar age. And he met this other young boy who was a similar age with him, who was actually a Jew at that time and was in the camp. The German boy, after witnessing the Jewish boy was starving most of the time, then brings bread and food to him often, and their friendship deepens with time. At the end, because of the German official wanted to use poison gas to kill all those Jews in the camp, and his son was actually accompanying the Jewish boy.
但是呢，从民众的说法来讲，在一个坛城当中，在一个
and eventually was killed also by his own father's order.
学习秘法的话，那这叫做民众的这个金刚道路。Anyhow,
it's not necessarily saying that there are
friends, and therefore
the German
boy
purposely lost his life to help his friend, his Jewish friend. But my point is that
就是金刚道友之间就是互相的
through some kind of connections, and they were they became friends and they died together due to this kind of connections. My point is that we are all friends in the sense that we've taken empowerment in one mandala, and we are Vajra friends, we are Vajra Sangha. We should not pretend to be one kind of person to smile sweetly in front of one another, but hiding a knife behind the facade of your smile. Lots of our Sangha members here, when you are wealthy, when you have talents, when you can contribute, when you have fame, you will notice that everyone is very nice to you, everyone respects you. But all of these texts follow off because of impermanence, the happiness that you once
had will also deteriorate because of impermanence. At that time, at the time of not having anything, do you still have any friends around you? I sometimes think that some of our Sangha members who left the home and come to this distant place,
When
you are ill, you don't have any family members over there to help you and to take care of you, but maybe there are friends who can take care of you. Maybe there are people who don't really talk to you when you're healthy, when you're happy, but there are people who are right over there by your bed and taking care of you when you're sick.
大家都就会这个沾美啊，就沾阳啊，就是拉着哈达，拉着鲜花， 拉着这个各种各样的东西来控制这个。当你一旦就是这个人身体从这个身体也好，这个名声也好，心灵也好，全部下落的时候，我们很难。这个就为希望我们其他的什么上的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们经常的话呢，就是我们 我们现在都是也在向一些，哪怕是这个一个月当中能帮助一个病人的人，就也是有一些病人是特别可怜的，就是他什么什么这种这个福报都没有，就是不管是财富上也好，就是人脉也好，什么都没有，就是在这个时候有些
they don't have anything, they don't have any connections, they don't have any money, they don't have anyone to take care of them, but they are ill. Then as a good person, if you can stand in their shoes and really concern about them, really take care of them, really extend your helping hand to them, that will be remembered by the person for a very, very long period of time. So on one hand, do not conceive the kind of friend who are your real friend, otherwise you will be so disappointed. The second is that we should gather all of our efforts to help the kind of people who do not have any resources. Just as some religions in this world really gather together, they really unite with each other when they are confronted by others, they hold different weapons, they will use different formats to fight back. But of course, in Buddhism, we're not like that. We don't use such violence, or so we're rather mild. But because of our mild attitude, people often feel that it's okay to. It's okay to look down Buddhism or have Buddhism as the kind of target to fight
or to 寄送的方式来说啊，就是治那个肺和方癌这个恶的，就是这样的朋友，就是亲是这样的朋友，这是第一种嘛。刚才讲，然后那个慈悯就是慈悲心呢，就是慈悲心呢，就是存着是别人的这样的这种这个亲友。还有呢，就是利益啊，就是饶益别人。
Then the Buddha started summing up in verses saying that the friend who is a helper, the friend through thick and thin, the friend who gives good counsel, and the compassionate friend. the four types of friend that we just learned.
那么这四种亲友呢，就是慈亲、耐可亲，就是这四种亲友的话呢，我们可以呢就是一种可以亲近他。
And
那么这四种这个朋友呢，
associate ourselves with them.
啊，素父亲就是那么有智慧的人的话呢，就是他一定是依附啊这个亲近。
Would definitely associate themselves closely with such kind of friends.
这个朋友的话呢，就是亲重无等亲，就是在所有的这个亲朋好友当中呢，是最好的。
Out of all kinds of relatives and friends,
相比的就是这么一个很好的友。那么这些朋友呢，我们怎么样这个亲近他？
These four kind of friends are the best of all. There's no one other than these four that are better.
那么他就是特别的去关心和关爱自己的这个亲生
子。And one should attend to them carefully like a mother.
虽然我们这些朋友
，to her own child.
这个血缘关系的，就是真实的这个亲人，就是不是这样的。
Lots of friends.
但实际上呢，就是他就是我
，you would consider as a good friend.
就是
，you probably don't have any blood relation or blood connection.
我对真正的这个这样的朋友的话，那就是要去这个
对待，But to such kind of friend, you should associate with them,
就是经常呢，就是
and take care of them, to pay back gratitude to them,
有那个享受的。这种这个，那么一起享受，有这个痛苦的话，那就是一起感受，就是这个很重要的。让我们快乐享受的时候，能全部都来享受，就是。然后遇到痛苦的时候，所有人都跑了，就是那是不讲良心的，不太很好的。
When we need help, but also you should share your happiness and anything that you enjoy as well. So this time when we are learning the Sikalabhata Sutra, we should all improve our interpersonal relationships. People sometimes may feel that
再也不理你了，就是这种人是现在啊，就是在这个时代当中。
It's very difficult to get along with others because people change very often. They will change their mind very quickly. One day they're good, and the other day they're not good with you anymore. Maybe it's the media, maybe it's the westernized.Maybe it's the westernized
education. 就是就结束啊，就没办法结束。为什么这样一下子就犯念了？为什么这样？就是
if you change too quickly, people don't, people can't handle such quick changes. What happened to that person? Why did he or she change so fast? What just happened? I don't get it.
即使你不能就是就是一直这个长期下去的话呢，那么就是也不能变成这个恶缘和臭缘。这一点是作为大乘佛子们，大家也应该记住。有些我们就经常就是好多那个金刚道友也好朋友啊，那么跟世间人呢，就是对待的过程当中，自己的心态，我昨天也讲了吧，就是就稍微这个宽容一点。
As I said yesterday, I think we should be more inclusive, we should become more big-hearted, we should not have too much ego, nor too weak, because if you possess such personality, then you won't have a good interpersonal relationship with anyone. If you don't have a good interpersonal relationship, then what's the point of studying Mahayana Buddhism, talking about the Bodhisattva's actions and talking about I perceived I've seen my main deity in front of my eyes. What's the point of doing all those if you cannot even maintain a good relationship with the people around you? I dreamt of my deity, I dreamt of Manjushri, I dreamt of Samadabhadra, I dreamt of all the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. I abide in this emptiness, abide in this state of great emptiness. But once you woke up from that, then What's the point? And once you woke up, you can't even get along with anyone. Then what's the point of practicing Mahayana? I don't want to talk about. High level of realization, but I really want to just talk about my own mistakes, my own bad personalities. Otherwise, if you can't even do that, how can you talk about the shravakas, the pratikas? From time to time, you have a sense of looking down at them, but if you can't even correct yourself, how can you criticize others who are Buddhist or not, who are shravakas or Mahayana practitioners? And once you can associate yourself with such kind of friend, then you should be maintain such steady relationship. Another way of explaining it is when one wants to associate oneself with such kind of four good friends, you should have the kind of mind that's rather persistent and that's very... steady. Do not change very often. Today he is my good friend, tomorrow he's my foe. You should not do that. Even in this world, in this mundane world, you don't see people often doing that. I think it's very important to have the steady personality. In Tibet, we say that what marks a good person is that a person treats you for the whole life as if it's only a day. In the morning, he treats you like this. In the evening, he treats the same way, and he treats you the same way. Every day, his mentality and his way of treating you is exactly the same. His mind doesn't infatuate very often. He doesn't change based on small things. The first day is very upset because of a little thing, and the second one is extremely happy. I see that people have such great differences, maybe because of our previous karma, maybe because of the garbage food that we have. Maybe I am like that too. Maybe I'm not a good friend either. I change very often. At first I wasn't so happy, and then I became very happy. So let's not change too much, because it brings suffering to people around you. Also to yourself, it's not really contributing any helpful factors to your own practice
either.
Do not change back and forth often. That's how you should rely or should associate yourself with a friend. And this kind of person who associates himself with these good friends, then they are the kind of person with full precepts. And they are just like the fire blazing and illuminates everyone and everything. Once a person has good friends or surrounds himself with good friends, they can also have the ability to bring happiness to others. So let's all aspire to become the kind of person who can bring happiness, the light of brightness to others. The Sangha friends, the Vajra Sangha friends, the colleagues, the alumni, the roommates, any types of people around you, You should have them as good friends or transform them into good friends. And maybe we should stop here. I think my nose stopped running naturally.